This is, I want to show how to render leather, and I'm sure some of you would be interested in having leather pieces. This is more of a biker jacket. So again, you can approach with leaving a lot of highlights or doing it later. So it depends what kind of shine you have. So for mine, I'm just gonna do all black to start with. And I'm gonna add highlights later with white color. So it all depends on your approach. If I had super shiny leather, then I would not do all black. I would just kind of leave a little bit highlights. But this is more kind of matte, not so shiny leather, and I'm gonna cover the whole thing. When you see like the silhouette that I already drew, it has those kind of like wavy outer silhouette, and that's because leather is soft, and depending actually on what kind you have, if it's lambskin, if it's cow, if it's I don't know, alligator or whatever skin you have, you'll have different varieties. So again, you want to look at the character of the item, the jacket, how well it drapes, how soft it is, because all of it will be reflected in your design. So I just did all black. Now I want to add some structure to my jacket with my white pencil, because my seams are lost at the moment. So these are drawing back the seams. And maybe some folds, so I know where things are. Here I have some zipper as well. I have a zipper on the sides. Okay, so now I'm gonna add highlights with side of my pencil. So I'm gonna use this like this and move to add some white on highlighted areas where I think it's, where the leather would be kind of whiter. And then you can go back and even highlight a bit more if you feel you want to use more of pencil. Again, it depends on the actual texture of the leather you're using, or you can use some paint and just add some more white with your, you know, bulletproof white, and add more of a high shine. All the shine on leather is a bit this wavy, it has this wavy pattern, so make sure you don't lose it. You add that kind of a waviness, and that will help to kind of show, oh, okay, this is like more of a high shine leather look. And then you can finish with your gel pen, adding your seams. And this is the zipper, so I'm adding the zipper on in this case. right next to it, you can use your again black marker to have a little bit like second layer, more emphasis at the shadow areas. So more emphasis, I mean, like make it darker, and then clean up some areas where you feel, oh, I did a little bit too much white or too much, you know, gel pen or whatever. So you can always fix it with your marker. That's kind of what we're doing right now. I want to clean up the edges with again my black gel pen, because this will be a little bit like more organized. Usually I don't use black gel pen for outlining, but in this case I want a little like cleaner edges. I want to put some black next to white gel pen to make it pop more and kind of clean up the areas that might look a little bit messy. Because with leather, again, like it depends on your drawing style, you can do more of a looser rendering and have it messy, but most likely leather is going to be a little bit like a cleaner and sharper medium, so you want to keep it a little bit more tight in your approach. Here I feel like I need to again dilute a little bit of that highlight. I think I kind of cleaned up too much, so I'm gonna put it back and make it a little more softer look. I like this better. All right, so you have your camo and leather rendering at the moment.